was.
My bad, guys. I'm getting alright.
Huh?
So there we go.
Scoot over closer to you here.
Alright.
So everyone knows we're homies.
Did you get a drink?
Whoa, dude. We can't be talking about alcohol in the video. Yeah, no, I got me some Starbies.
Figure out all these wires. Alright. I'm good. Well, I just didn't see your drink on this because this is where I had mine, so I didn't know if you had.
Well, okay, yeah, turn me down just a little. I don't know why I'm louder today. That's weird. Yeah, that's probably better. Yeah, well, I was just scared that, you know, if we knock it over, it's going to break or something because of the glass.
It might.
I mean, I can put it back down there.
I don't care where you put it.
Good morning, son. This is a rough start, dude.
It is.
You know, and I'm tempted to say just restart, but because we like to keep everything just as raw and authentic as possible, you know, we're just going to keep it rolling.
Yeah, that's what we do.
Yeah, Gonzales and Galleon Pod. It's never our fault, you know. Like we normally say, we don't make mistakes. You know, we're not like most humans. Most humans, you know, they're quick to make mistakes, and they'll never admit to their faults. We don't make mistakes, so we don't even have to, like, even attempt to admit to our mistakes.
Right.
Right. And, it's just, you know, it just goes, I don't even know where I'm going with this.
Honestly. Yeah, I don't either. So,
anyways, we do make mistakes, people. Like the fact that I should not drink Frappuccino before doing a podcast, because now everything I say sounds so weird. Like, so, like.
I haven't noticed.
Well, that's good. I appreciate that. But, yeah, anyways, I'm still not caught up to date on which podcast this is.
This is number 58.
58. Thank you. This is why we have you on the team today.
Yes.
So, 58, episode 58, which means only two more episodes until episode 60.
Right.
And, you know, we try to have a guest every once in a while, normally on, like, relatively big shows or big episodes. The last guest was Jesse, and that was episode
56,
which wasn't, like, a significant number, but it was, like, the last episode of the season. Or not the season, but the little break we had.
Yeah.
And, but the last guest we had was Elena and Bradley, right? That was for youth camp, and that was camp. Episode 50.
Mm-hmm.
So 60's not like necessarily like big number or anything like that, but you know,
maybe it's another milestone.
Yeah, so you know, maybe we can throw somebody in or something.
Yeah,
so
we can spring somebody. We'll see.
Yeah, but I tell you what, dude, when we get to episode 100, which would be like February or March or something. I don't know. But, you know, we're going to do something crazy. I'm not quite sure. And, you know, our big brains over here will think about it. And like we said last week, probably procrastinate and not have it lined out until 30 minutes before. And we're just like, hey, we need you on the show today. Yeah. So.
Yeah, I don't know what we could do for 100.
Like you know, it just has to be something big, because like we always like I feel like we do some like big things, have like some cool guests and everything for like special episodes. I mean, like our Christmas episode, we had like 5 people in it, and that was fun. But you know, for 100, like you just got to like go out with a bang. And so
maybe we'll get our first celebrity.
That's what I'm saying, like maybe by then we'll be famous enough to get Casey Musgraves in here or something.
Yeah, man,
she's like always the like the first one I think of, just because like she's from Golden. I don't think she would ever see this, or nor if she did, I think,
or care.
Yeah, I don't think she would really want to, but you know, we'll swing by and talk to her mom and try to convince her. Like, listen, ma'am, you probably don't even know me, even though I live like a quarter mile from you or less. But we run a podcast, and we're actually doing a fundraiser, Hairs for Mares. And
right.
We know that, you know, your daughter's just a dime store cowgirl and probably loves horses. So we were just wondering if maybe we could talk with her about that and just have her on the podcast and just, you know, see her thoughts, Landon, and just, like, you know, see where she stands about Harris Ramirez. And, you know, we know she's a compassionate lady and just wants to be there. And so we would like her to be on this podcast. And I think that would go over well.
Maybe. Maybe. I think she rode a horse in her movie thing, didn't she?
Oh,
her album Star movie. Star-Crossed
movie. That's true.
Yeah.
I bet that horse didn't have real hair.
Under the bridges or something?
Had to, like, donate that hair to that horse.
Maybe.
Being, like, that luscious of hair that the horse had. Yeah.
I think it's weird when artists make movies for their albums. It's kind of cool, though.
Yeah, but, like, she called it a movie, but, like, is it, like, a movie? Because all of this is just a music video for every single one, right? Every single song or whatever.
Yeah, they all connected, though. It was, like, it never stopped.
Yeah, but, like, was there any dialogue other than, like, singing? Like, actual acting and stuff? Or, like...
There was probably, like, little transitions.
It was weird, though, because there were, like, actual actors in it, right? Like, the girl from You, I think, was in it.
I don't know.
Pretty sure. The girl that plays Love. I think she was... I don't know. It's something weird. So, I didn't watch it, honestly.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I know Halsey did one. But it was, like, an HBO Max exclusive, and I didn't get to watch it.
You depressed about that? Or?
I like Halsey. I would have liked to watch it. Gotcha. I liked the album that she did it for, too. But did you hear about Taylor Swift? You know, she did, like, she recorded her, like, tour or whatever.
Yeah.
They're making a movie about it.
They're making a movie about a tour that just happened?
Well, yeah, it was like a documentary. Like, they filmed
it. Well, yeah, that's what I figured. But, okay.
Yeah, and the pre-sales went up today, and it broke records. Like, it broke Spider-Man No Way Home records. Like, pre-sales. Like, that is...
For the movie?
Crazy. Yeah. No, for real.
What?
It's all the people that are too broke to actually go to the thing.
You know what I don't understand is, like, the hype around Taylor. Like, no hate towards her, I guess. Like, she has some really popular and fun songs, but, like, these shows selling out, like, the AT&T Stadium sold out, like, three nights in a row. That's wild. Like, I feel like there's other artists that are, like, I don't know, bigger than that.
Just, I don't know. I've never dove into her music catalog.
Like, never, you truly become a T-Swift fan, I guess. Like, because if you are, like, then you, like, become insane.
I don't even know, like, the latest song I've heard of hers. Like, honestly, I can think of the one album that has, like, is it the one that has Welcome to New York on it? No, it's, like, 1980 or something.
Yeah.
Like, I listened to, like, two or three songs from that when it came out. But, like, I feel like that was the last thing I listened to.
Yeah, that album wasn't terrible, but that song does hit different, like, when you're flying into New York. I purposely, like, played into my headphones. I wasn't, like, trying to land. It's kind of cool. It's like, boom, doom, boom, doom, boom, doom. Welcome to New York.
There's a scene in one of the shows I was watching recently, and they referenced that song because they went to New York. And they're like, all right, class. Well, as in the words of one of the most famous singer-songwriters of all time, welcome to New York. And I thought it was so funny. I thought it was hilarious. Like, because I was expecting some, like, I don't know. I guess, like, she is super popular.
Yeah, it's weird that, like, she's going to be, like, I guess, go down in history as, like, you know, like, queen or Journey or something, or Backstreet Boys. I don't know. It's, like, weird to, like, think, like, that.
I would for sure think she's probably, a legend.
Yeah.
And it also helps that all these artists, like, like, got their careers while social media was a thing. I mean, come on.
I mean, for sure.
I mean,
just, like, the fact that, like, there were so many artists that are coming up now that I feel like literally were no one, but they made one really good song that got famous on TikTok or whatever, and then all heck broke loose, and you know, now they're famous. Isn't it weird?
Like, imagine if, like, social media was around when, like, Michael Jackson was getting his start or something, you know?
You see, and then that's weird, because, like, I feel like if it was, like, famous then, it would change history as far as there'd probably be other artists that we had no idea about that are, like, that would pop up. But, like, the artists that, like, say, like, Michael Jackson and Elvis or something like that, like, if there was social media, do you think they would have got as popular, or do you think they would have become more popular? Or I just wonder, like, how social media would have taken, like, such a different approach to music. Like, Elvis, you know, his was, like, his style was completely different, and like as far as the dance moves went, everybody hated it, you know.
Thought he was being possessed and crap.
Yeah, but like if social media was a thing, do you think he would have got more hate for it, or do you think it would have been like even more of
Yeah, it would have went wild. All the moms,
yeah.
do not let your daughter go see Elvis, you know.
Post on their Facebook.
He's being possessed. Demon stuff.
I don't know if y'all read about this Elvis guy, but he says he's a Christian, but he is flaunting his stuff in the stage in front of all these young women.
Making them take their clothes off and throw them at him.
Yeah.
It's all like a hypnotic thing.
Yeah. Don't take them. Well, you know, this goes back to last week, you know, be a better parent. So, but yeah, that'd be weird. But yeah, it's also just strange, like the times we live in where social media is such a big thing, where literally, I mean, you can get famous so easy. Like you can be a social media influencer, you know, just literally you're just traveling, you're getting paid to travel, and you just like show your experience, do your vlog or whatever, like with YouTube, and then like with music, you know, just make a really good song, and then it just blows up, because like. Way back in the day, you know, no social media or nothing, and people had to get famous the hard way, and like really word of mouth and really grinding and just, you know, losing money at this point until they finally got famous and got rich. But then there's like the next generation, which is like more so our generation, I guess, almost a little younger, I mean a little older, because I don't consider myself in the generation of getting famous through TikTok. I'm already like, you know, I'm 23. I'm just kind of over that. But then the generation of our time, which, like I said, these people are a little bit older than us. But like Justin Bieber, he got famous on YouTube. Just posted a video of him singing. And, you know, if you went back to look at that video right now, you'd probably cringe and think it wasn't that great. But for some reason, it blew up. And then
Well,
all of a sudden, overnight sensation.
Yeah, well, I mean, like, it's still like the same thing. I mean, like Tori Kelly too, right? They just posted covers on YouTube.
She did.
I'm pretty sure Tori Kelly.
Well, like Shawn Mendes, I think he was also
Yeah.
YouTube, but he
It's like
was
the same
like,
thing as posting on
same,
TikTok.
yeah. Well, like Justin Bieber and Shawn Mendes, they posted videos and like everyone found them attractive. Which, looking back, is like super weird because I remember so many people finding Justin Bieber attractive, and the kid was 13 at the time, or like, you know, in that age, he was really young. I was like, man, this is kind of weird.
Girls like him.
Yeah, but I'm saying like adult, like. People over the age of like 18,
Oh.
you
Well, they
know.
probably just thought he was cute. Oh, he's a cute little boy.
Yeah, you can't say that, no. Especially like nowadays,
Yeah.
like it just wouldn't go over well. If a lady said that, you know, it'd be like, you know, okay, whatever. But that's another thing. Like, I guess we're kind of like really getting off topic. But like for guys, it's such a hard world to live in. Because like, you're like, oh, that's a cute kid. I guess it doesn't sound like really bad. Especially from anybody, if you're like, oh, that's a cute girl or that's a cute boy, it just sounds terrible. Like, it just sounds weird saying that out because, like, even though you mean nothing about it, but there's so many people that, like, I guess, could pervert it.
Yeah, everyone's so easy to jump at something.
Yeah, so,
But
but at the same time, there's also good reason for people to jump into that because there's just a lot of bad things in the world, so.
yeah. Well, also, like I guess it's like I was gonna say like another like thing to, like get famous for music. Back like I would say like, when we were growing up was like being on Disney Channel. Like you be on Disney Channel, you get your song and then like tchoo, there you go. Pretty much it. Like you just had to like get on Radio Disney, you know?
Oh, like, but you send your song to them or something, and then you can get famous, or
Well, no. Well, I mean, like you just had to like land something on Disney.
oh,
'Cause like even if like you just landed like I don't know how to say this, like
like a small role.
yeah, even like a small role in like the Disney Channel original movie, but if you sing a song, like if you were part of one of the songs, like.
Yeah.
They'd be like, oh, get this kid a microphone.
Yeah,
Yeah.
and then I'm taking off doing that, which I feel like most of the artists that did that were successful enough to like be able to survive, but none of them really got famous. Famous. The only two I can think of is Ariana Grande, but that was Nickelodeon, and then Hannah Montana or Miley Cyrus. And I feel like they're the ones that are actually like still like kind of relevant. I can't really think of much of anybody else that's still like does music and that, you know, you're still hearing stuff from, like, today.
Selena still makes music.
She did, and hers wasn't bad. And, like, she had a phase where I, like, really enjoyed her music. But it was still the point where they're still, like, promoting it on Disney Channel. Like, she was out of Disney, but they're still promoting it, I guess. But, like, I don't really listen to her anymore. I don't know who all does or doesn't, but, like, I don't hear much about her unless I'm talking to you.
She just released one.
Yeah, I think that's what you told me last week.
Oh, is it? Is that my song last week?
Well, you said her single and Miley both released songs.
Oh, yeah. I'll be single soon. Inspire. I like that song.
I'll be single soon?
Yeah, that's what she's saying. Like, the song was, like, her, like, saying, like, she was about to break up with her boyfriend. Like, she didn't know how to, like, tell him, I guess.
So she wrote him a song saying that she's going to be single soon?
Well, it was just a song about the process, I guess. Like, I don't remember how the chorus goes right now. Something like, I'm picking out my dress, I'm picking out my shoes, because I'll be single soon. I don't know. She's about to drop that boy.
Yeah, but she was also, like, about to go out and, like, find a new dude.
Yeah, I guess so. I don't think she liked the guy.
Who is it, Miley or Selena?
Selena.
Oh, so she's single.
In real life?
I don't know. Like, I'm just saying, like, is she available for you?
I don't know.
I just know, like, you know, that's like one of your dream girls.
Your boy, you know?
Huh? Yo, Selena, holla. That's what it's going to be, dude. Somehow you're going to, like, connect and then end up dating. And then at that point, it'll be right at our 100th episode and she'll be our guest.
That'd be cool.
You know, forget about Casey Musgraves.
From Grand Prairie. Like, it's not super far.
Yeah. But, how often does she go there?
Right. I think a little bit more than she used to, maybe. Because, like, she has, like, a little sister. She posts about her little sister a lot.
Mm.
So, I don't know if, like, well, she might have, like, moved them out there, though.
Could be. I wouldn't want to move to Cowie, honestly. Pretty place, but
I don't know.
Not my bunch.
Yeah. Anyways, Taylor Swift. I don't know about Taylor Swift, man. I don't listen to enough of her music. I mean, I don't know. I guess I'm a little salty that she, like, broke Spider-Man's record. Because I'm like, what the heck? That was, like, such a big thing. But also, like, it's fiction.
It's just like, yeah, but it just doesn't
and, like,
make sense.
Taylor's, like, a real person. So it's like, yeah, cool.
It's
happy
a
for you.
Documentary, though. Like, I just don't understand.
Even one of my cousins posted on Facebook. She's like, I've never, like, pre-ordered tickets before, but I did for this. And I'm like, home. Like, you've never, like, pre-ordered a ticket for anything?
I just,
but apparently it's, like, you know, it's, like, sold out, though.
So, documentaries are, like, that interesting. I've seen some, but, like, maybe they're just, like, I'm in the crowd. I want to see myself.
Oh, yeah. That could
dude,
be cool.
That means, that'd be, like, you know, that movie could break records as far as, like, the most amount of current living humans in the world in a movie.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
Because, like, everybody went to that concert or that tour except for us. And they're all in that movie.
Maybe.
And one of them all had to sign NDAs.
No.
A kid.
It was probably, like, in the fine print on the ticket. It's like, you will be recorded.
Yeah. But, like, if you go to a concert, it's just kind of like a given, I guess.
Oh, yeah, because they always have photographers and stuff.
Yeah.
And you know that, like, Taylor says the same crap everywhere she goes. Like, the little, like, jokes or, like, whatever. Like, the whole set's always the same. So this way they can just pick which night she sounded the best or, like, which night this.
And then
the crowd reacted the best.
Yeah, they reacted the best. Yeah. I don't know. See, like, for me, dude, if I ever, like, went on tour or whatever or, like, you know, some churches, they'll have multiple services and it's the same pastor. Like, I can't do that because to me, then you are just like repeating yourself. And, I just feel like I'd get annoyed myself. Like, say I went on a tour and I said the same thing, repeated myself. As far as the songs go, I wouldn't really care. But, like, in between sets and, like, you know, sometimes they have like an emotional moment and stuff like that. Like, I feel like it wouldn't be real, it wouldn't be authentic. And I just feel like it's not, it's fun. And then you'd be like, you know, oh, Dallas, this is my favorite city. And then go to the next city. Los Angeles, you are my favorite city. But y'all lying every time.
You seen the thing that Sabrina Carpenter does? Like, everywhere she goes? She has, like, a little tune that she sings. And, like, she changes it for, like, each city that she goes to. Like, ah, dang. I don't even know how the tune goes.
Like a melody? Or
yeah, like a little melody thing that she does, like, at the end of her concert. Like, she, like, says, like, da-da-da-da-da, da 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 da. The second line, like, will rhyme with whatever city she's in. And one more line, and then she'll say something about being in that city. It's pretty cool. It's a pretty cool way to make it unique. Makes it a
little more personal.
Yeah, because then, like, if you get drift, like, oh, she did it three places, and the next one, oh, I wonder what they're going to say about.
Yeah.
Wonder what she's going to say about Dallas or something, you know? Like,
yeah. It's like with the, but, yeah, so that's another thing, like, so the Holvey tour that we went to, was it Beautiful? Beautifully Made or something? Yeah,
the Beautiful tour.
Yeah. So, you know, like, you know, he's doing his thing, doing his set, and he's having kind of the emotional moments, but I feel like it was still real. But then they had that, like, just completely unplanned moment, music messed up, and then just, like, praise service kind of broke out. That's something cool and, like, really real. It's nice, like, when...
The music messed up?
Yeah, so, like, you know, Forrest Frank was doing his testimony, and they had, like, a loop of a music playing, and then eventually when he gets done with his testimony, I guess it goes straight to the music. Well, I guess he was taking a little bit longer, and then it went straight into it. And they're like, hey, like, cut it back. And the DJ's like, I can't do anything. And then finally, Colby's like, all right, cut the music. And then it started speaking, yeah.
Catch any of that.
You remember watching the Holy Spirit move in the building?
I guess not. God. I was waiting for the glitter.
Yeah, for real.
No. Side I didn't context. Catch that at all.
Yeah, man. It was pretty cool, though.
I don't know. Connor said that he was, like, watching his stories, though. And, like, they did the same thing somewhere else.
Like, what?
Yeah.
Well, was it, like, the exact, like...
No, like, the, I mean, not the thing messing up. The music messing up. But, like, him, like, stopping the music for Forrest to tell his testimony and everything.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he gave, like, the exact same thing. Because, like, I'm like, I don't know how he didn't know it wasn't in Dallas. Like, the video... I guess because it was like 2 or 3 days later.
Well, I saw one like the day or two later, and it was definitely in Dallas, the one I saw.
I don't know.
Huh.
Oh, well.
Fakes.
It's not for us to say.
Exactly. We're just a podcast giving our own opinion. And, you know, that's what we're always going to do, you know. And that's what's nice, you know, having... We're just kind of two dudes always hanging out, best friends, and we believe a lot of the same things, but, you know, we also disagree on a whole lot of things. We have different opinions, so, and that's what you get at the Gonzalez and Galleon podcast, is, you know, real.
Yeah, authentic. 100% all caps, straight facts.
No cap.
No, all facts, no caps.
As long as 100%. Nick ain't here. We going to get real.
Amen.
And that's a promise.
Amen.
Amen.
And, you know, until that day he
so far tries it's not to make a problem, so.
Yeah.
What was I going to say? Well, I feel like that was our intro. I guess we can hit those sections.
Yeah, we probably should.
Boom.
Oops.
Roasted.
Oops.
Okay.
Local news. Anchorman Stephen Galleon right here.
With Ryan Gonzalez.
Local news.
There was another fire or something on 1799 the other day. There's a lot of fire trucks. I don't
know what that was, though.
Yeah. Well, my mother-in-law said that she heard it was a house that burned on fire, but I never smelt it nor saw smoke. So, you know, I can't confirm anything.
It's also Labor Day.
Today is Labor Day, and, you know...
We didn't mention it last week.
The only thing I did not do today was labor.
Bro, facts.
Or go into labor. Same. I didn't do that either. But I did... I shot some hoops with your brother, actually. Played a little basketball, bottle and cesto. And,
Cool.
Yeah, it was a good time. Got breakfast with you, actually, today, and so...
Yeah, got breakfast, yeah. It's pretty good.
Yeah, actually, wasn't that bad.
I ate almost everything. Almost.
Did you get the early bird?
Yeah.
It's probably why you didn't eat everything.
The breakfast special.
Oh, okay.
No. You were going to say I didn't wake up early. Is that what you were going to say? Is that a joke?
No.
The early bird? Oh, because I had to wake you up at 9:15.
No, I wasn't going to say that, but I did.
Oh, come on.
I didn't know I would go up. It was like 9:30, I thought, and I was like, I'll just text him and see if he's awake. I didn't know, like, ding, would wake you up.
It did.
Sorry, dude.
It's fine.
You can't, like, just, like, read a message and, like, go back to bed.
I mean, I could have.
I guess it would have been rude.
That kind of would have been rude.
Yeah, I appreciate you not doing that. I would have been very upset.
And then we would have been like, it would put us on the verge of getting lunch instead of breakfast. If I went back to sleep.
We almost did get lunch. I didn't eat lunch today because of that reason.
I didn't either. No, let's just say that.
I did eat a Snickers right before I went to play basketball. You say Snickers or Sneakers? I guess it's more Snickers, right? S-N-I. You gonna mess something up. It's a fan in the
computer. Hear the computer breathing. What was I going to say? I had a moo latte. I met my parents at Dairy Queen because they didn't. I mean, they ate lunch, but I was like, I just got back here from Uncle Bubba's. So, but I'll go. So I got a moo latte. It's pretty good. I don't get moo lattes much. I was like, dang, that's kind of fire.
Yeah, that's pretty good. Often. I have trouble drinking things like that just because I know like how much sugar is in it, and I immediately feel fat. But they're good. Kind of like a frappuccino at McDonald's. It was so good.
Yeah, frappe.
Frappe.
Yeah. Sharpe. I think McDonald's are better.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But the meal latte was pretty good.
McDonald's will kill you, but, you know, their breakfast, fire. Their fraps, fire. Their ice cream.
Their chicken nuggets, fire. Know.
Bro, come on. Dude, they had the spicy nuggets at one point. Those are really good.
They have spicy mustard that you can just use.
Spicy mustard.
Yeah, John Heat, bro. You don't
like honey mustard?
No, it's just regular mustard, but it's like got spice in it.
Yeah, I don't know. I feel
no,
like
it's
that.
Pretty good.
Okay,
it's pretty right. good.
No, I had a yawn. Oh. I was really trying to get all that oxygen to my brain. So
yeah, that's about all I did with my Labor Day. Yeah, came back and did some laundry.
Yeah, dude, me too.
Watched some TV. I helped my dad unload a drill. Because they got a drill today.
Ooh, fire.
Yeah, it's their anniversary purchase. Their anniversary is Wednesday.
This Wednesday?
This Wednesday.
Well, man, that's fantastic.
I know, I need to get them something. It snuck up on me. September snuck up on me.
Yeah, man, your birthday is coming up. It's like a week away.
I know.
Yeah, a little over, but.
It'll be 24.
24. Only one thing funny
old.
Than that.
Huh?
Is it only one thing funnier than that?
You're right. 25.
25. Yeah.
Look at this boy trying to make SpongeBob jokes.
I was just trying to make it happy for your birthday. And, you know, I feel like it's succeeded, so.
Yeah.
On to? Unless you have another local. Work hard. Yeah, not a dang thing here.
I actually got one. You see these scars right here?
I was going to ask you about some of your scars the other day.
You want to know how I got these scars?
You want to know how I got these scars?
You want to know how I got these
scars? The Batman. The Batman. Was that actually in the movie or is that just Hizzy?
That's Hizzy.
Okay.
Yeah. The Batman. Wow, the Batman. Because it starts with the, come on, hit me, come on, hit me, come on. I want you to do it. Come on, come on. Boom, it just like hits him. Oh man,
we got to watch that.
The Hizzy nurse is so funny. She also shows up in the X-Men one because like the red like teleporter guy shows up and she's like, "Oh Lord, the devil in the ER!" and like, runs off. So funny. Oh man, I honestly haven't watched the Hizzy in a while.
I haven't either. I probably should.
Yeah, I probably should.
I wonder if the new one about Homecoming. I mean, Far From Home.
No way home. I mean, they probably had to.
Yeah,
sure. I feel like I probably would have watched that one.
I don't know.
Anyways, I fell off the dock at work.
Oh no.
Yeah.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm making it. I was there. I wasn't all by myself, but one of the other employees was in the restroom. My boss had to step out for a little bit, and then the other employee was on lunch break. So I was like kind of there by myself. I wasn't there by myself, but I was working by myself. And some guy pulled up, wanted 80 bags of corn. So I said, gosh dang it. So he pulled up against the dock, and then I went and got Junior, who was on his lunch break. I was like, hey, this guy wants 80 bags of corn. It's like, I know you're on your lunch break, but can you just like pause and help me? He's like, yeah, sure. He gets up, I go outside, and then when I get outside to start looking for corn, like three other cars pull up. So he got stuck inside helping the people inside.
Mm-hmm.
So I was out there loading it. And I was just moving so fast that I misjudged the little bitty, like, part that's in between the dock and the trailer. And my leg just went through it.
Just one leg? So you just kind of actually got this one, too, though.
So I kind of, like, fell sideways through it. And the guy didn't want me to help after that. He's like, dude, I got it. I get it. I'm like, no, you're not going to get it. I got it. But, like, it wasn't until, like, 30 minutes after that it started hurting. I guess it was the adrenaline of, like, knowing I had, like, 80 more bags to load.
Yeah.
But, yeah. That's battle scars right there. Scraped
you
up
and got you bruised.
Yep.
Mm. Mm. But you survived by the grace of God.
Amen.
Hey.
Amen.
So that's my work story.
Yeah. Yeah, no, man. Nothing interesting over here.
All right, then.
Paying bills.
Entertainment.
To be completely honest, I don't think I've watched anything.
Boo.
Yeah, I know. Sorry, man. Trying not to rot my brain by the television. Okay.
Well, I finished Asteroid City, and we kind of talked about that this morning.
Oh, yeah.
It is just kind of a movie about nothing. Yeah. It's like kind of a waste of time. It's got some funny parts in it, but like not a lot.
Very visually colorful.
Yes, very beautiful.
But yeah, then, I don't know, I just didn't like it.
Then I finished season 4 of Never Have I Ever, which I loved. I've loved that show the whole time. It's pretty good.
Heard of it, have nothing, I don't know anything about it.
Yeah, I cried in the finale, actually.
Ooh.
Yeah, it got me.
You're a real man.
Yeah, for sure. And then I had just started the movie Before Supper. Adam Sandler has a new movie on Netflix. And it's like his actual daughters. I think it's like his actual family, like his wife and his daughters. And it's about like, it's kind of like a teen drama movie. It's called You're So Not Invited to My Bar Mitzvah. They're like a Jewish family.
And is it actually, is it spelled bar mitzvah or bat mitzvah?
Well, I guess it's bat mitzvah. Isn't that just the way it's spelled, though?
I don't know. I thought it was just, like, spelled B-A-R, bar mitzvah. Maybe it is bat mitzvah. But
bat mitzvah? I don't know.
No, I thought it was playing words. I just saw it on Netflix. I didn't know it was Adam Sandler, though.
Yeah. So it's actually kind of cool. I mean, like, they all have really good chemistry.
Yeah.
Because, I mean, they're a real family.
Yeah, you
so it's kind of cool. Yeah. Yeah. And it's funny because, like, one of the daughters in the movie is, like, definitely his favorite. I wonder if, like, that's, like, actually his favorite daughter. And it's, like, that's the way it works.
I wonder if it's kind of like a running joke type thing, you know, where some siblings say that she's the favorite and stuff.
Yeah, so they do.
But really, it's not, yeah.
Or if, like, the other daughter is, like, actually his favorite. So then he, like, in order to get closer to this daughter, he made her the favorite in the movie, maybe. Could be.
Could be. Could be.
Could be.
But, we don't know for sure.
That's true. It's for sure. For sure. But I don't know. It's pretty good so far.
Yeah.
Like, some teen drama stuff is too much for me. But, like, Never Have I Ever. Like, I freaking love that show. And, like, this movie's fine. One of the girls in it looks a lot like Kristen Monk, though. Like, I'm not even lying. Like, something about her, like, just kind of reminds me of her. And I don't know what it is. Maybe she doesn't look a lot like her. Maybe it's some of her mannerisms or something.
A lot of times it's something like that. Yeah, like, mannerisms.
This girl reminds me of Kristen Monk.
Yeah. Speaking of teen dramas, I heard that you like, you've been watching Riverdale, right? You said you really liked that?
No.
Yeah, no, I think that's what you said.
Mm-mm.
Yeah.
False.
Oh. Nah, I'm joking.
Wrong.
Nah, whatever.
Never seen an episode in my life.
That. I think I watched the first episode with Jesse, and I think she maybe watched, like, 2 or 3 after that. I don't think she even watched anything since then from that. It's just some garbage, honestly. And, you know, that's my personal opinion. But I think I'm correct. So, you know.
Yeah, that's what... It's made a lot of seasons, but I've never really heard anyone talk good about it. So, I don't really understand.
Well, it's I like think that,
people just hate watching it.
Yeah. So, like, I feel like shows like that are just, like, not good for you to watch. It's, like, just too negative. And then, like... 13 Reasons Why, like, that's kind of like a negative, can be a negative movie. It depends on, like, if you're, like, already suicidal and stuff. I feel like it's a movie you really shouldn't be watching, or show. I've never seen it myself, but, like, some people, I feel like they like it, and, you know, they don't struggle with that, so it's not a big deal. For me, I watched Bates Motel. I couldn't even finish it because it was just very, very negative. Maybe if I watch it now, I can like just start where I ended and finish it. But I just felt like when I'm watching a show like that, like my whole outlook on everything is just more negative. I feel like I'm more just dragged down.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, that's why I took a big gap in between watching The Boys. I can only watch so much of that show.
Yeah,
and it'll get me. And I was like, nope, I'm gonna take a break.
To me, it's a very entertaining show, but I agree. That's one of the shows where it's like, yeah. Because I think I watched like maybe the first two seasons all in one because I didn't start watching it until season two. But yeah, like I don't know what season I'm on now, but now I have to watch season by season, and I kind of take my time.
I think the fourth. I think they're working on the fourth season. Pre-strike. I don't know what's happening now. But I think they got like a spinoff coming out. It's like about college students. It's called like Gen Z. I think it's the name of the show.
And they just have powers or something?
Yeah. Because isn't the stuff called Z? Compound Z?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, I think it's called Generation Z. Like with that Z. So I'm guessing it's like kids who've gotten... I don't know, I'm just like, The Boys mixed with college sounds like a horrible TV show. Like, it sounds like it's going to be nasty.
Yeah, probably will be, honestly.
Yeah.
Probably going to pass.
Probably going to pass. Like, also Euphoria, I feel like the same way. We were talking about, like, I feel like that could just, like, make you so depressed.
Yeah, just throw in too much garbage in it, you know, just like. Things that sometimes, I mean, they're real in the world, but it's, like, when they're portrayed, it's just not... I don't think it's good for your mind to like, watch things like that.
Yeah. Yeah. So. I'm pretty sure, like, that the only thing that shows, like... From what I've heard, it's only about, like, sleeping around and drugs. Like...
Yeah.
I don't really know if there's, like, much more of a plot to it.
And I think that's what, like, Riverdale is in Murder.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, I think Riverdale even got, like, satanic for a little bit. That's what I've heard.
There's some
ritual stuff.
100% believe that.
Yeah. I don't know.
You need to get on Netflix and watch Jesus Revolution.
I saw that's on there. I still haven't got to watch the movie. I need to watch
Jesus Revolution. I rewatched it just the other day on Netflix.
Yeah, I saw that it was on there.
Yeah. Good movie.
Yeah. There's some quite a bit of movies on Netflix right now. I need to watch that.
Yeah.
Yep. But I guess that's it for entertainment for me.
Yes, sir.
Let me think. I don't really know what all came up.
There's a guy that I think mentioned last week called Ethan Gander. Well, he ended up releasing a single, I guess, Friday, and I listened to it. It's called Ghost of You featuring Adair. I liked it. It was pretty good. Good artist.
I definitely feel like there was a song that came out this week that I liked, but I can't. Oh, did you listen to that song that Lecrae was in? Mm-hmm. Is that called, I think like the actual artist name, or called like the Obros or something? You ever heard of the Obros?
The Obros?
The Obros. But Lecrae was in it, and I thought it was pretty cool. I mean, like, their parts were okay, but I thought Lecrae's part was pretty good.
Yeah. Huh. What was it called?
I can't remember now.
Gosh dang, brother.
I can picture the cover art, but I can't think of what the name was. Mm. It's like them sitting in an altar, not an altar, in pews. And like both of them are in a pew, and then Lecrae's sitting in the pew in front of them. Something like maybe like My Way, Going My Way, maybe, or Coming My Way.
Hmm.
Something like that. Look it up. Obros and Lecrae. That's all you gotta look up.
And it'll pop up.
Yeah, look up Obros and Lecrae.
Just like 1 O? Or O-H?
It might be like O apostrophe bros, maybe. O bros. Maybe you can just search Lecrae and then go to Featured On.
I need to. Lecrazy.
Lecrazy. Crayola.
Crayola.
Yeah, wasn't that it? Yeah, that was it.
Where?
Appears On. Down there. Appears On.
Oh. Going My Way.
Going My Way.
By the O Bros.
How's it spelled?
O. Yeah, pause for you and then bros.
Yeah.
So, I don't know why. I hope this doesn't sound bad, but I was not expecting these guys to be white. I don't know why, like, the way you're, like, talking and then, like, just the name, the Obros, I don't know why. It just didn't seem like, just, like, very, look like college white dudes.
Yeah.
But,
yeah. Maybe I'm guessing good. They probably have some successful music for Lecrae to just hop on a track. Dude, I don't know.
You never know. They could have just been.
Maybe they, like, popped off on TikTok.
Honestly, probably so.
I wonder if they're, they were Christian. I mean, the lyrics were very Christian.
They were Christian? Oh, dude, all their, that's a little creepy. All their singles are on the pew.
They're probably, like, getting ready to, like, drop an album then.
This one's called Holy, but it don't look so holy. Kind of creepy.
Huh. Amen, brother.
Amen, brother.
I'm going to, like, listen to their music for real.
Wait.
I bet they're getting ready to release an album since it all looks the same.
Yeah.
The album's going to look like that.
They look like they must be fun to listen to, though.
Under dang, there's a lot of them.
Statement. Are they, like, worship singers?
Maybe. I don't know. That one was rap.
Yeah, like, all these look like rap, but that one's, like, they look like... It's called Wooden Zoo Wonder. Like, Wouldn't You Wonder, I guess? Wooden Zoo Wonder? I don't know. I'm gonna
they might be, like,
one.
The next... Social. I always thought it was cool to have, like, social with, like, two people.
Yeah. Like, that's, I feel like, not it really... had been hard, but...
Yeah. Like, I feel like that's, like, not really a thing. Like, yeah. Two rappers. Like,
I feel it'd be more fun, though. Like, at least you go on tour, you know you're always going to have at least one person that's, like, your buddy, I guess.
Yeah.
And they're, like, totally different guys, I feel like, too. Like, they're similar, but, you know, one's, like, hardcore. We used to be in drugs and stuff, and the other's, like, real fun, funny guy.
I saw that Marty just became like a cast member on a podcast called The Relevant Podcast.
Huh.
Apparently Derek Minor is a cast member on it too. I was like, how come I never heard of this? I was looking at it and they have like big name people on there. Like Rainn Wilson was on it not that long ago.
So
the guy from The Office?
Yeah.
I'm like, so is this like a Christian thing or like, I don't know if like Dwight Schrute came to Jesus or not. I don't know. I should listen to it, I guess.
And Jesus.
Bears, beats, and Jesus.
Yeah.
Bears, beats, and Babylon. And Bethlehem.
Bethlehem.
Yeah.
Yeah, Bears, beats, so who's like the main cast members? I mean, like just, so I guess we're cast members of the Gonzales and Galleon podcast, right?
Yeah.
So like hosts, I guess.
Yeah. So well, they just said welcome to the cast. I feel like it's like a big, I mean, I feel like it's like a, like there's like five or six of them.
Interesting.
I didn't like, I guess I didn't recognize any of the names, or they just didn't like pop out to me. But Derek Minors did. So I was like, oh hey, I know him.
Yeah.
Bro just dropped an album apparently, or like, yeah, a song or something.
I think so. I didn't listen to it.
I didn't listen to it though.
Yeah, I haven't really like listened to him honestly in quite a while. So.
Me either. I don't know. I might. I guess I should listen to it just to do it.
Yeah. Most deaf. Most deaf.
Most deaf. She love me most deaf. Then work out. Right. That's what we need. We need to get. We should just like start like getting people to like spam CHH artists in our comments.
And then like give like, them a minute.
Yeah, like day one of everybody tagging John Keith until he replies. Like get all of our followers tag John Keith.
Let's do like Tour Deshaun. I feel like he would. Be like someone that'd be like, you know what? Yeah, sure. I'll go chill with him. I feel like he's a pretty chill guy.
Because I've already talked to him. They're just like, you've already got an inside thing.
You already got connection. On, come on.
Come on.
No, honestly, I think I would like really enjoy to talk to him and stuff.
Yeah.
I don't really know John Keith like as well. I mean, I haven't seen him in concert, but towards Sean, I mean, I felt like he was pretty genuine. So.
I mean, we could say the same thing about Not Clyde. Why don't you get Not Clyde on here? You've already been in a song with him.
Yeah, I don't know how genuine he is.
Dang, bro. You can just call people out like that. Now he's not going to come on here.
I'm just saying, I don't know.
And now everyone that's friends with him is going to be like, well, he just sneaked this Not Clyde for no reason, so.
It goes, I just went away all of our chances. I'm dying. Well, you know, I say that because, I only say that for one reason. That's because he was in my song and, he didn't like advertise it, you know.
Uh-oh.
That's why, you know, I just don't know how genuine he is about, you know, reaching out to other people.
Did you pay him to advertise it?
I paid him in general and a good sum at that. Gosh dang, he should have freaking promoted or at least shared our story. It didn't even pop up on his like on his music page, and that's like probably his best song yet.
Oh, yeah.
No, but this is on fire. At least enough to be like, I like it. On the single. Come on.
I like it.
I do too.
Another person would be Mowgli, because he follows me. He views all my stories.
Even your podcast stories?
I mean, if I post something about the podcast, he views it.
You should just like post some of the podcasts. Like, yeah, so we're running a podcast. We're trying to get just somebody that's, you know, relatively bigger or like a bigger name, star, whatever, on the podcast. Reach out if you want to be a part of it, and then let me know if you see the story. Maybe he just slides up, be like, "Hey man, I don't know if you think I'm big time enough, but I'd be interested."
Is that what Mowgli sounds like to you?
I feel like all that yelling and screaming he does, he has to have like some sort of rasp.
Oh man,
just talking voice.
I think it'd be cool. I like Mowgli's recent music a lot.
Yeah,
his like he calls it hyper rock or whatever it is. John Heat.
Yeah, it's a fire for sure.
Yeah, and then like he went back to like rapping on that Indie Tribe album. I thought it was good. I liked all of his parts. But dude, that'd be cool. Like if we just get like one like, I don't know, like relatively famous CJH artist, and it goes well.
Yeah, dude, I'd be so nervous.
Next thing you know, Lecrae's on the couch.
Lecrae in your house. Hey, Mr. Moore. How do you feel about it? He'd probably like walk in like all excited.
Man, what the heck is this couch, man?
He would just see like our setup and be like, no, you know, I've worked with so much better than this. This is a slap in the face to my career.
I feel like he would make a joke about it, but I feel like Lecrae's a cool guy.
I hope.
No, dude, I feel like if he like saw this, he'd probably walk in and be like laughing, like, man, y'all gotta be kidding. And then we're like, no, he'd be like, all right then, let's do it.
Yeah. Well, I drove all the way from Atlanta. Or flew all the way from Atlanta.
Like, cause I mean, if like, obviously, I feel like if we like worked up to where we could get Lecrae, it wouldn't be this.
Oh, but, we would like, I would gut out your whole room, or you know, we'd like go all out. You know what I mean?
Yeah. I feel like we'd already be like in like somewhere different if we were like big enough to have Lecrae. Like we wouldn't even be sitting here.
Yeah, that's
like, true. We would have already been out of this.
Yeah, but, I know.
Social club also. I've talked to Marty quite a bit.
That'd be cool. Even if we just get half of the social.
And he's like podcast. He's a podcaster now.
Yeah, I mean he talks in microphones.
Yeah, he knows what to do.
That'd be pretty cool though. But yeah, man. I'd be so nervous like as far as like the interviewing process goes. With doing like this
also because like I don't know, like I feel like you have to do your research, but also like if you don't it might make it better because like obviously we know Tory Deshaun's from like St. Louis.
Do what?
Like we know Tory Deshaun, he's from St. Louis. Yeah, right. And then what he kept saying, so it's like we know that, but like we don't like know that much about him, so it's like, oh man, it's like, but if we didn't go to that concert, like, man, so tell us where you're from, and he'd be like, well, yeah. You didn't even Google me before you had me on here.
Yeah, or like you didn't listen to anything I said in the in the concert. I think it'd be cool because he'd be like, "Oh, you're so
icebreaker questions, man."
Come on. Be like, "You're from St. Louis."
What was that like?
You know, yeah, like what's that like? You know, I ain't never been there, so like, what is it like in that city? You know, what's your craziest story, or like, what's your favorite thing to do there?
Yeah,
you know,
tell me like what the signature food is in St. Louis. Something
ooh,
like that.
I wouldn't mind knowing that.
Yeah, because you know, like if you go to like Philly. You gotta like, dude, get the Philly cheesesteak, you know?
Yeah.
That's what Will Smith always talking about.
You go to New York, man. Hot dog.
Pizza.
Or pizza. Their hot dog's trash, man.
That bacon, egg, and cheese. You didn't watch Ninja Turtles? I want the bacon, egg, and cheese. And they start talking like in their New York accents.
You know, oh, like all the turtles?
Yeah, with all the bacon, egg, and cheese.
The bacon, don't forget egg,
the
cheese.
Bacon. And the, we outside. That's my favorite part of that movie.
Yeah, it's pretty funny.
And then Michelangelo starts twerking. And they're like, yer.
Such a weird movie.
Oh, man, I loved it.
Yeah. No, that's a voice crack, I think. On two?
On two.
Heck nah.
Is it heck nah?
I think so. Oh, reflect to deflect.
Reflect.
I know what you reflect on. Reflect. Deflect.
I reflect on trying to skip reflecting to deflect.
Yeah, man. I reflect, Well, the fact that I assumed that the Obros were not white men, and, you know.
And assuming that not Clyde is not a genuine person.
Yeah, but, you know, it's just personal.
I feel like I should reflect. I feel like I said something about Taylor Swift, but I don't think I did. I think I was relatively nice. Well, I guess I can reflect and deflect on not listening to her in the past 10 years.
Yeah, I guess we can reflect and deflect on, like, not being T-Swifters. I'm not a T-hater, but not the T-lover.
T-lover? Yeah. That's like a new rapper name right there.
T-love. T-lover.
No, wait, Toe Love. Isn't Toe Love like an actual singer?
Toe Love?
Toe, like Toe.
That's called, that's a foot fetish.
Toe. Oh, shoot.
Watch your profanity.
I don't know.
Huh.
Tuvlo, that's what it is.
I don't know, man. I'm not in with the times.
Yeah. Yep. Yeah. She's on this, like, you're gone and I gotta stay high all the time to keep you off my mind. Oh, that's Tuvlo.
Oh, I bet to me, I thought that was a rapper name, honestly.
Nah.
Interesting. Is she like from Australia or something?
I don't know. That song got hard, though. I'm going to download that song.
Yeah. Now you can go to Hegnall's.
Okay.
Hegnall!
Is Lecrae not a genuine guy?
Hegnall!
He's probably pretty genuine.
Bro is a genuine guy.
Yeah. Doing music this long and, like, staying in the faith like that, you know, he has to be pretty genuine.
Yeah. For sure. Let's see. I feel like we were talking about something in the beginning. Like, I don't know. But we could have said heck no, too. Because something like that just goes back to bad parenting. What were we talking about?
Did it have something to do with Kacey Musgraves? I think, like...
What? No, I don't think so. Kacey Musgraves, man, that goes back to bad parenting right there. Man, come on.
She turned out.
Reflecting deep.
Oh, man, I don't know. It was like around that area, that time.
Yeah, I feel it was towards the beginning. I can't remember what it was. Oh, well, whatever it was.
Heck no.
Heck no.
Let me think. I had just thought of another one. Dadgummit. Oh. Do you watch Riverdale?
Heck nah.
Do you watch 13 Reasons Why?
Heck nah.
And do you watch Euphoria?
Heck nah.
Well, maybe you do, but you maybe shouldn't.
Or maybe you're just stronger minded.
That's true. Yeah. We're weak.
Weak!
And what's wrong with that? Boy, oh boy, I love it when you fall for that.
Oh, weak. Do you sing in a podcast?
Heck nah.
Yeah, can Ryan and Steven vocalize?
Heck nah.
Dude, no, there have been some times we sang and it sounded pretty fire.
Yeah.
That one?
Every once in a while.
That one was not it. So, but yeah. I don't know, man. That's I guess that's all we have for the show today.
Yeah, I feel like 15 minutes is usually our mark.
Yeah, it's like at least when we're trying to wrap it up. Guys, man, share, stream. I think it has
tag John Keith.
It had something to do with getting famous on TikTok and stuff, didn't it?
I don't know.
Anyways, share us on your TikTok, your Instagrams, your Snapchatters, and Facebook. And guys.
And be real.
And be real.
If that be real goes off while you're watching our podcast, you better freaking post
best
it.
Best believe. Guys, so just share this and, you know, like with all the famous people you know, if you know anyone, and just like spam it.
Yeah, for real.
Because we got to get a big guest for episode 100. Honestly, I'll be fine with it anytime before, but episode 100, it's going to be around the March time, I think.
Everyone go tag Jack Black right now.
Do we want Jack Black? I mean, I guess I wouldn't say no, but
I think that'd be awesome.
I would prefer someone who is in the Christian industry so I don't have to go back and edit out cuss words. But I'm not opposed. I'm not too picky.
Bro, Jack Black was in Kung Fu Panda. He ain't cussing that.
Yeah, but like, he had to stick to the script. This is a podcast. We just do what we want.
You just tell him, hey, man, we appreciate if you just don't use language. He probably would.
Maybe. I mean, we appreciate if you just go back to your Nacho Libre days real fast and just...
That's it, dude.
What?
We get Jack Black, but he's in character as Ignacio.
Bro, he's so funny.
We interview Ignacio.
Dude, that would actually be really cool.
That would be the best.
Dude, what if like we
tag Jack Black right now?
What if we change our podcast, dude? And instead, all we did was just do interviews to people, but we interviewed
their characters
instead of actors, just their characters. Dude, that would be great. Trademark, Gonzalez and Gallen. We came up with this just now.
Boom. Don't steal it.
We might not do it, but you can't steal it now. So
yeah, we called it.
Called it. Called it.
Don't steal it. Bad.
you heard it here all first. Right. Oh,
if that's the case, I got to think of someone else that we got to have on here.
Spider-Man.
Tom Holland.
Can you do an unmasking reveal real fast? Oh, I don't know, man.
Yeah. Andrew Garfield. Be cool. Andrew Garfield, Peter Parker. Let's see. Who else? Dang. There's got to be like someone else. Oh, we should get Zach Galifianakis. This is David Gantt.
That'd be funny.
So, David, tell us about your baby powder technique. Yeah, well, what you doing?
That'd be a good question, actually. Yeah, now we'll get something figured out. Maybe Air Bud.
Who cares about Air Bud, dude? Like nobody.
They might. Dude, the Minutemen.
Bro, the dog don't even talk. The Minutemen? That would be wild. Just like, oh, man.
It might be like the most like, viewed YouTube podcast video of all time if we did that.
And I wonder like what the copyright issues are there. Like,
oh, and they had to go like through the company. And
yeah, like, I wonder if like Disney has to okay that for us to have the Minutemen here.
It's a good question. I bet so, though.
Probably so.
Hmm.
But dude, if we could have Nacho Libre sitting right there, that'd be the best. We could have like corn out here for him to be eating.
And some cheeps. Did you not tell him it was the Lord's cheeps?
And then we could be cooking cookies. I smell cookies.
Pretty funny.
Yeah.
Him getting back in the role, man. We should just scratch this whole podcast and just start doing that. Yeah.
All right. This is podcast number one of us trying to get Jack Black to come on here as Ignacio.
Please tag him.
Please tag Jack Black.
As many times as possible. Yeah. Guys, we love each and every one of y'all. But we'll see y'all next week. On Gonzalez
Gallien out.